Hi, my name is Philip, and I am here from OpenView Education. I hope you are all keeping safe and well. Welcome to OpenView Education's story time. Today, I will be telling you a story called
I Want to Change the World.
This story is all about, well, me. So, are you all sitting comfortably? Let's begin the story. My name is Philip, and well, I was just like you. I went to school with my friends, and I always tried my best. I was a whiz at playing chess, and I was super duper at sport too. But I had a wish, the biggest wish of all. At night time, when everything was quiet, I would lay in bed and think, I want to change the world. I want my name in lights. I want people to hear my name and think,
that's Philip. He changed the world.
I didn't really mind how I did it. Maybe I'd be the cleverest person at school. Maybe I'd become a chess grandmaster or a sporting superstar. It didn't really matter to me.
I just wanted to change the world.
So I would go to school and listen and learn, answer all the questions I could and get all of my homework done. But still, I'd stare out of the window and daydream and think, I want to change the world. I thought if I worked hard enough at school, always did my homework, scored enough goals and won enough chess matches, then one day I would change the world soon enough. But one morning I woke up and I went downstairs to have breakfast with my parents. They said they needed to talk to me. Philip, there's been quite the change. Things are a bit different, my mum said. For a while, we need to stay inside and be at home together. The world must work as a team, and everybody is staying indoors for quite some time. I sat quite still. What did my parents mean? Stay inside. But what about school? I asked. My mum explained that school would be at home for a while. What about chess club? I said. My dad said I could play chess online. What about my football match? I exclaimed. My mum explained that I could still practice my football in the garden. I didn't understand. I didn't know what was wrong. I felt cross and upset because I couldn't do all the things that I wanted to do. I rushed away from the table and sat in my bedroom. I stared out of the window and thought, how am I meant to change the world when I can't even go outside? I stayed in my room all day. And when nighttime came, I couldn't get to sleep. So I got out of bed and I stood on the stairs. I could hear the tapping of keys on a laptop. I walked downstairs to investigate. I saw my mum sitting at the kitchen table with her laptop. My mum asked me what I was doing up, and I told her I couldn't sleep. I looked at my mum's computer screen, and I saw lots of emails on her laptop. Wow! That's a lot of emails, I said. My mum explained that was part of her job. She did it every day at work, but now she was doing it at home. I realised I'd never seen how hard my mum worked before. I hadn't realised that things would be different for her too. Good night, mum, I whispered. I ran upstairs and got back into bed. I drifted off to sleep with many thoughts going round and round my head. The main one being, I want to change the world. The next morning, I woke up early and crept downstairs. My mum's work was still at the kitchen table. I thought about how hard my mum worked to help our family and I wanted to help. I knew we couldn't go outside, but I could still do something nice. I thought long and hard, and then I thought, I know, I will make breakfast for my family. I put cereal on the table. I laid out bowls for everyone. I put some bread and jam and butter out, and a special cup for my mum. When my family came downstairs, they saw what I had done, and they were full of joy and happiness, and we ate breakfast as a family. I turned to my mum and said, "Thank you for working so hard, mum." My mum looked up from her special cup and smiled in surprise, and then she gave me a smile that met her eyes. That night, I lay in bed and drifted off to sleep. I was so happy I had helped my mum, yet still one thought remained. I want to change the world. The next day, I woke up and went downstairs. My dad was waiting for me at the kitchen table, and he looked tired. He asked me if I was ready for some learning. I had never learned outside of school before. I thought about my teacher and my friends. I sat down at the table with my dad. I worked hard to listen and learn, to practice my very best concentration. "Where did you get this work from?" I asked my dad. My dad explained that my teacher had sent it to him online. I hadn't thought how things would be different for my teacher too. I thought about how even though a lot of us couldn't go to school at the moment, my teacher must still be working so hard to help me learn at home. At the end of the day, I saw my dad do a really big yawn. I hadn't thought about how things would be different for my dad too. He'd never been a teacher before. I thought about how my dad was also staying inside, working hard to try something new. Later that night, when I was drifting off to sleep, I thought about how lucky I was to have my teacher and my dad, who were working so hard to help me learn. But still, one thought remained. I want to change the world. The next morning, I woke up early and tiptoed downstairs. I sat at the kitchen table with my colouring pencils and paper, my brow furrowed, my hand moving across the page. When my dad came down the stairs, he looked at me in surprise, for before him were two thank you cards, one to send to my teacher and one to be given to him with the words, "Thank you, Dad." I turned to my dad and said, "Thank you for working so hard, Dad." My dad looked at me in surprise, and then he gave me a smile that met his eyes. Later that afternoon, when learning was finished, I looked out of the kitchen window and saw my brother in the garden all alone, kicking a football against the wall. He looked so sad. I opened the window and called to my brother, "What are you doing out here by yourself?" My brother explained that he was just practicing football and that he missed his friends. I hadn't thought that things would be different for my brother too. Later that night, I lay in bed with thoughts of my brother going round and round my head. But the main thought was still, I want to change the world! The next morning, I woke up early and tiptoed downstairs. I made my way out to the garden. I put out cones on the grass. I drew football posts on the fence with chalk. Finally, I positioned the football, ready to play. When my brother came downstairs, he opened the back door. He looked up at me and said, "What on earth is this for?" I said, "I miss my friends too. But you are my friend at home and my brother. Even though we can't go out to the park, we can play here together and help each other." My brother looked at me in surprise, and then he gave me a smile that met his eyes. Later that night, I lay in bed and drifted off to sleep. I had fun playing with my brother, but still one thought remained stronger than ever. I want to change the world. The next day, I woke up early and tiptoed downstairs. I thought I would be the first one up as usual. But when I arrived downstairs, I couldn't believe my eyes. Before me were my family, grinning from ear to ear. My mum had put out breakfast with my favourite bowl and cup. She turned to me and said, "Philip, thank you for making me breakfast. I felt appreciated, so I got my work done even faster than usual. My teacher had sent me a letter that read, "Philip, thank you for sending me a kind card. I felt inspired, so I made new lessons for everybody." My dad had made a big sign that read, "Thank you, Philip." He said, "Philip, thank you for making me a nice card. I felt confident, so I was able to teach you more." And then my brother stepped forward with a picture he had drawn of us playing football together. He said, "Philip, thank you for helping me to practice football. I felt supported, so I scored my first ever goal in our garden." I looked up at my family in surprise, and then I gave them a smile that met my eyes. I realised that changing the world was in the small things. And even though I couldn't go outside right now, I was still able to help people. I was able to help my family. And when we are able to go outside again, I know that I will still always support them and take care of them. Then my family stepped forward and all three of them sang,
"Three cheers for Philip. Thank you for changing our worlds."
So, well done for listening so well to the story. Did you enjoy the story today? Great! Well, for your homework, I'd like you to think about three things. Number one, how did I change the world? Number two, what could you do to help the people around you? And number three, is there anything that you might do now after you've heard this story? Thank you so much for listening, everybody. And we'll be back soon with another story for you all. I really hope you enjoyed it today. Goodbye, everybody!